Hey everyone, and welcome to a Knowing Your Enemy guide, this time for Frost Mages. If you've been looking for some tips on how to deal with one of the best classes in classic PvP, you've come to the right place. It's no secret that mages are capable of dealing absurd damage, both by casting from range or even in your face with instant casts. Not only that, but they're also the most mobile class in classic World of Warcraft, as no one else has anything that even comes close to blink for mobility. And, as if that wasn't enough, they also have a ton of control, with Polymorph, Frost Nova and Counterspell, letting them play Puppet Master to their enemies. To kick things off, let's take a look at the enemy's game plan. What do mages want to do to you? But before we do, be sure to hit that subscribe button and bell to get notified every time we release guides just like this one. And after watching this video, let us know in the comments below if it was helpful, and don't forget to leave a like if you want to see more guides for countering other classes. Alright, so through our research and discussions with some of the best mages around, we've identified three critical goals that mages will try to accomplish in order to successfully dispatch with most of their opponents. Their number one goal is all about mana. Mages will never want to engage in a fight if they're not full on mana, as once they're out of mana, they become completely useless and can pretty much lose to any class. In order to deal with this, mages can of course use their mana gem to recoup a small amount. They can also channel evocation to gain mana on each server tick. And if they're ever able to land polymorphs in a 1v1, that gives them then the opportunity to drop combat and drink water to regen mana. Good mages will even play around the server tick and sit down momentarily for just a single tick of water when needed. Their other two goals come down to how they approach combat. More often than not, they're focused on gaining control and distance by utilizing Polymorph and Frost Nova before going for damage from range while their enemy can't touch them. While doing this, expect them to fake cast against players with an interrupt, or to simply outrange any interrupts to gain control over the fight. Mages will usually try to gain control against classes that are not good at sustaining themselves if the fight prolongs, so anyone they can eventually kill if they're able to sustain themselves through the opposing damage by resetting the fight with Novas or Polymorphs. Their second approach to combat focuses entirely on getting out as much damage as possible in the shortest amount of time. Here, they'll be sitting on top of you, burning through their mana quickly, utilizing high mana cost spells, like max rank Cone of Cold, Arcane Explosion, and Fire Blast, to chunk you down. While doing these, they make good use of their Frost Nova to abuse Shatter, and deal even more damage. Expect to see mages play this way against Warlocks and Hunters, who generally win the long game if they're able to keep the mage away from them. Alright, so now that we have a good idea on what a mage's game plan usually is, let's take a look at some specific strategies you can employ to counter what mages usually do. So, we mentioned a mage's first goal is to never go out of mana, so how can you play around that? Well, starting with a very simple approach, if you're ever able to catch a mage in open world PvP that's low on mana, just go for the kill. They'll be super vulnerable, and even if you're not playing the best class for beating a mage, warrior, you'll most likely still win. Beyond that, some classes are simply better at playing the long game than others. Warlocks, druids, and basically any class that can just play to live while forcing the mage to burn through their mana and eventually go can take down a mage in this fashion. This also means you'll want to prevent the mage from resetting and drinking up to full mana, and stop evocation when they go for it. So if you're able to sustain, do so and just win on mana. Next, in order to deal with mages who primarily want to gain control over you, there's a few key things you'll need to accomplish in order to prevent this from happening. First and foremost, your interrupt needs to be exclusively used on Polymorph. If you interrupt Fireball or Frostbolt early on, you'll be letting a mage get a free Polymorph and essentially give them full control over the fight for some time. This of course means you also need to avoid letting the mage fake your interrupt. On top of your interrupt, different classes have access to different abilities they can use to avoid Polymorph. Great examples of this would be a Shaman using Grounded Totem or a Rogue using Vanish the moment a Polymorph is about to land. There's also a few items you can use to avoid Polymorph, such as the Skull of Impending Doom, Dark Rune, and Restorative Potions. So, to summarize, if a mage is focusing on gaining control with Polymorph, do absolutely everything you can to avoid it. The final game plan you should be looking to counter will occur whenever a mage is trying to play in your face, and going for a quick kill whilst abusing Shatter. First, if you're a class that benefits from dragging out the fight, you'll want to keep the mage away from you. Warlocks and Hunters are a great example of classes that should be utilizing their crowd control to keep the mage away and prevent them from dishing out tons of high, instant damage. Then, regardless of whether or not you're stacked on the mage or keeping them away, you'll want to reduce how often they can shatter spells to lower their overall damage. In order to do this, you'll need to quickly break out of Novas to prevent them from shattering spells and slow down their damage. A great way to do this is with a free action potion. Referred to commonly as FAPs, these potions in turn make you immune to both slows and roots for the duration of the potion. Or, if you can't break roots, then take the opportunity while you're in a Nova to use abilities or items that will reduce the damage you take. For example, making use of the Gyro Freeze Ice Reflector or Hyper Radiant Flame Reflector on an incoming Shatter combo. Furthermore, don't forget that while mages can deal crazy amounts of damage in a short amount of time, they themselves are also incredibly squishy. So, if you're unable to self-sustain through their high burst, don't try to counter their first game plan by ooming them, and instead focus on all-out aggression. Okay everyone, that about wraps up this guide on how you can counter a Frost Mage's game plan. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you next time.